explain you through this video that advantage of protectionism. Now in your previous video I have explained you what is protectionism and types of protectionism. So today advantage of protectionism. Why protectionism is advantageous for many countries of the world? Why it is very important? So although there are many points in your book, so I have only managed to explain here. I'm going to explain your 5 points, which are only important for you, okay? So number one is need for protecting infant industries. Can you say that especially in developing countries? Now many industries they are still in infant stage. Still in what? Growing stage. So when they are in growing stage, they need lot of protection from the nations. They need lot of protection from the governments. Because if they are not given protections, they cannot develop, they cannot expand, they cannot survive. They will die in infant stage. They have to be closed in infant stage. So not to happen to such things, it is said that with the help of protection policy, the government can protect this one infant industries. Because when this protection policy, this infant industries product, they don't have to compare with the product of developed countries. There will be no competitors of them. So they will get sufficient environment, better environment for its growth and development. That's why for that also what happens is necessary. Now number two, generation of employment opportunity. Now generation of employment opportunity also, like this said that when there is protection policy, what happens? It will also create generation employment opportunity in the nations. How? It will create employment opportunity in the nations means when there is protection policy, what happens in the nations? There will be diversification of industries. Means there will be growth of number of industries and factories. There will be industrializations. The number of industries and factories will be added in the nations. So when the number of industries and factories will be added in the nations, what happens? That will also create what? Job opportunity for the public. Because more industry means more workers. And that will create what? Lot of what? Employment opportunity for the public. Now diversification on industries. Now diversification on industries means if there is protection policy in the nation, what means a country to be self-reliant or country to produce its all the required goods in its own country. Now country or the nation has to focus building different type of industry, making different type of industry which will produce different type of goods that is required by the nations. Now sometimes what happens due to political reasons or due to some many other reasons, what happens sometimes there may be not coming any foreign product in own country, will not be able to import any foreign product in own country. At that time what happens, if the country will not produce all the other goods which the country requires, what happens? The country has to suffer, the people of the country will have great problems. So not to have that problems, not to have such difficulties, it's very important that when this protection policy means at the time country has to keep focus on building out or on diversification of or adding the number of industry which will produce all the required goods in its own country. Now to preserve natural resources. Now it is said that natural resources are also the big asset of the nations. So what happens? It is said that if there is protection policy, what happens? The natural resources of the country also can be preserved. How? If there is protection policy, what happens? Other foreign industry or the industry of developed country, they are not allowed to take the resources of developing country to their own country. Why is there that? If there is no protection policy, what they do that? Industry of developed country, what they do that? They take the resources of the developing country in very cheap price, and with that resources, what happens? They produce some final product and they again sell that final product to developing country at a high price. So that is there in practice. So means due to that advance, the people of developing country they will suffer, So not to happen such situation, not to go on such conditions, it will advance. If this production policy means the resources of the developed country, developing country will not be taken by the what? Developed country. They will remain preserved in its own country. And what means the resources of the developing country will be safe. Now self-dependent means being self-reliance and at present advance, it's very important that all the nations of the world, they should be self-dependent. They should not depend on others. Especially what means developing country, they don't produce any all the required goods in their own country, they are all imports from other country. So when that happens, a lot of capital outflows, a lot of capital goes to other country. And when there will be any, some strike due to some, political, reasons, and if other country will stop sending any goods to the country, at the time they have to suffer. So usually you can take a example of our country also. When India will stop sending their, materials to our country, they will do what? Lot of, problem in the country. If India will stop sending the, food items, medicines, electronic goods, necessary goods in the country, what happens? Fuel in country, what happens? There will be a lot of problem in the country. And country has to, face, the people of the country has to face a lot of problem. So that is due to what happens? Lack of, industrializing in the nations. So what means? Not to happen, such a problem in the nations. It is very important that country should apply this protection policy and country should, give proper, environment for the development of infra industries. Country should focus on, diversification of industries. Country should focus on what? Diversification of industries. And what means? Country should try to produce all the required goods in own country. And country should try to be what? Self-dependent. So today, from this video, I have explained you about the advantage of what? Protectionism. Thank you all of you. Okay, this was today.